Pub Coast Studios in Oklahoma City. You're watching Thundercover with Darnell Mayberry. I'm Mike Sherman. Thundercover is driven by Byford Buick GMC. Nobody treats you better than Byford. Darnell, the subject is Royal Ivey, the guy who was buried deep on the Thunder bench a month ago and all of a sudden has become the indispensable reserve. What happened?
Well, Eric Maynard going down, Tavo Cephalosha going down, both with knee injuries. It presented an opportunity for Royal Ivey, and he's made the most of it. He's really come in and played defense like the Thunder needs him to play, filling in for Tavo Cephalosha, whether it's at point guard or shooting guard. He can play both guard spots, and he's really been the key in terms of steadying this ship defensively.
They got enough scoring, Darnell, so they're not looking to him for scoring. But now Scott Brooks says in a story that's on News OK at this moment that he's actually pondered starting Royal Ivey.
Yeah, I mean, it's an interesting strategy if you look at it from Scott Brooks' standpoint. Daquan Cook is much better with that second unit, and if he can continue to come off the bench and knock down shots with James Harden and Nick Collison and those guys and stretch the floor, I think that balances out the rotation. You're basically having Tavo Cephalosha light in Royal Ivey in that starting unit if he decides to make that move. It's going to be interesting because Daquan Cook hasn't really shot it all that well lately, and if Royal Ivey can come in and provide that defensive intensity from the start like Tavo Cephalosha was doing, it might be worth considering.
This is Royal Ivey's second season with the Thunder. He came, and it looked like, Darnell, that he was taking over the Kevin Ollie chair of soon-to-be coach, senior member of the team, guy who sort of coaches from the in uniform. That's not how it's happened. In fact, he's minimized the impact of the injury of Eric Maynard. He's minimized the impact of having a rookie backup point guard. He's minimized the impact of Tavo Cephalosha's injury. And now, does this look like he will have a permanent place in the rotation when everything snaps back into place and Tavo comes back?
I'm not sure about that. When Tavo Cephalosha comes back, he's going to warrant 25, 28 minutes a game, just like he was before he got hurt. I think Scott Brooks is going to stick to that 10-man rotation, and Daquan Cook, he's going to need his shooting, I think, more than Royal Ivey's defense once Tavo Cephalosha comes back. But Royal Ivey has presented him a nice luxury. If Daquan Cook doesn't have it going, he can go with Royal Ivey and get some defensive energy and intensity like he had at Houston, at Philadelphia. Games like that, we've seen Royal Ivey come in and change the face of the game. We saw it last night against the Suns. On Wednesday night. So, you know, he can have that luxury and continue to play Royal Ivey. It doesn't mean that Daquan Cook is etched in stone in that rotation.
Thanks, Darnell. That's all for this edition of Thundercover, driven by Byford Buick GMC. Nobody treats you better than Byford.